In today's lecture, I'm going to focus on the proof of the convergence rate of the Nesterov accelerated gradient method. Let f be a function defined on Rn, and we suppose that it is a C11 function. That means f is a C1 function, and the gradient of f is Lipschitz continuous with Lipschitz constant L. And we also assume that f is a convex function. Let us define T alpha as follows. T alpha of x is x minus alpha times the gradient of the function f at x. And for simplicity, we're going to use T of x instead of T alpha of x. So the Nesterov's accelerated gradient method works as follows. We choose a starting point x0 in Rn and let y1 be x0. Let t1 be 1, and we pick a constant step size alpha in between 0 and 1 over L. For k greater than or equal to 1, we define xk and yk as follows. At first, we perform an iteration of the gradient descent. Xk is equal to yk minus alpha times the gradient of the function f at yk. That means xk is equal to t of yk. After that, tk plus 1 is defined by this formula. It's 1 plus square root of 1 plus 4tk square over 2. And after we have found xk, tk, and tk plus 1, yk plus 1 is defined as an affine combination of xk and xk minus 1. So over here, yk plus 1 is equal to xk plus tk minus 1 over t sub k plus 1 times xk minus xk minus 1. Okay, and now from here we can see some simple properties of these sequences. First of all, tk square is equal to tk plus 1 square minus tk plus 1. How can we get this formula? It follows directly from the definition of tk plus 1 over here. And by induction, we can easily show that tk is greater than or equal to k plus 1 over 2. This is a very simple exercise, and we can work on it at home, okay? And now, from this relation, xk is equal to yk minus alpha times the gradient of the function f at yk. Therefore, the gradient of, you can solve for the gradient of the function f at yk. It is just yk minus xk over alpha. Okay. Now, from this relation, we can multiply both sides by tk plus 1, and we will get it here. Tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 is equal to tk plus 1 times xk plus tk minus 1 here times xk minus xk minus 1. It's very simple and it's right from here. Now, suppose that f has an absolute minimum at x star in Rn, then 0 is less than or equal to f of xk minus f of x star, and is less than or equal to 2 times norm of x naught minus x star square over alpha times k plus 1 square. And because of this, we say that this algorithm converges with convergence rate big O 1 over k squared, because this is similar to 1 over k squared, and this is a big improvement compared with the convergence rate of the gradient method from previous lectures. Okay, so now I'm going to prove that this is true. Let me recall two important inequalities we proved from last time. F of t of y minus f of x is less than or equal to minus alpha over 2 times norm of the gradient of the function f at y square plus the inner product of the gradient of the function f at y and y minus x. And the right-hand side here can be converted to this form. So that we get f of t of y minus f of x is less than or equal to 1 over 2 times alpha times norm of y minus x square minus norm of t of y minus x squared. And this is true for all x and y in Rn. Okay, so we can see the previous lecture for the detailed proof of these inequalities. So let me go ahead and apply these inequalities to prove the convergence rate of the Nesterov accelerated gradient method. So we have the following. F of xk plus 1 minus f of xk is equal to this. It's equal to f of g of yk plus 1 minus f of xk. Okay, as you know, xk is equal to yk. Xk is equal to g of yk. That means it is equal to yk minus alpha times the gradient of the function f at yk. So here, f of xk plus 1 is equal to f of g of yk plus 1. And over here, this is f of xk. Now, we're going to apply the first inequality here for y equals yk plus 1 and x equals xk. So this is less than or equal to this. Minus alpha over 2 times norm of the gradient of the function f at what? At yk plus 1 square plus the inner product of the gradient of the function f at yk plus 1 and yk plus 1 minus xk. Okay? So again, this inequality follows directly from here, where y is equal to yk plus 1 and x is equal to xk. Okay. Now, let's continue with this. So, this is equal to, minus alpha over 2 times norm of this. Now, we're gonna use the following relation. This is the way we define xk and also xk plus 1. That means from here, you can solve for the gradient of the function f at yk plus 1. This is just what? This is just yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 over alpha. And then we plug in here. So this is equal to 1 over alpha times yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 square, okay? And again, we replace this one by that. So this is yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 over alpha. And here we keep the same, yk plus 1 minus xk. Okay. After simplifying, we're going to get this. Minus 1 over 2 alpha, because over here we get 1 over alpha square, and this is minus alpha over 2, that's why we get this. Times norm of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 square plus 1 over alpha times the inner product of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 here with yk plus 1 minus xk. Okay, similarly, let's write down this. F of xk plus 1 minus f of x star. Okay. Again, f of xk plus 1 is equal to f of g of what? Of yk plus 1. And then we subtract f of x star. Now, we follow exactly the same procedure, but we apply this inequality for the case where y is equal to yk plus 1 and x is equal to x star. So this is less than or equal to this. So we get exactly the same thing, but we should replace xk plus 1 by x star over here. So we will get this. This is less than or equal to minus 1 over 2 alpha, okay, times norm of xk plus 1. No, sorry. yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 square, okay, plus 1 over alpha times the inner product of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 over here with yk plus 1 minus x star. Okay, so let's see again how come we can get this. So again, over here, you get f of t of yk plus 1 minus f of x star. So let me work it out over here. So again, we replace by that. So we get minus alpha over 2 times norm of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 over alpha square plus the inner product of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 over alpha with yk plus 1 minus x star. And that's why we finally get this inequality. Now, let vk be f of xk minus f of x star. This is exactly what we want to estimate in Nesterov's accelerated gradient method. Okay, so we want to show that vk is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 2 times norm of x naught minus x star over alpha times k plus 1 squared. Okay, now from here we will see right the way that vk plus 1 is less than or equal to this. Okay, now over here this part can be written like this. F of xk plus 1 minus f of x star minus f of xk minus f of x star. And this is exactly vk plus 1 and this is exactly vk. So we get this inequality, vk plus 1 minus vk is less than or equal to this. Okay? Then vk plus 1 minus vk is less than or equal to minus 1 over 2 alpha times norm of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 square plus 1 over alpha times the inner product of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 with yk plus 1 minus xk. And at the same time, vk is less than or equal to, actually vk plus 1 is less than or equal to minus 1 over 2 alpha times norm of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 square plus 1 over alpha times the inner product of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 with yk plus 1 minus x star. Okay? So, now we're gonna multiply the first inequality by tk plus 1 minus 1 and add to the second inequality. Multiplying the first inequality by tk plus 1 minus 1 and adding to the second inequality, give us the following. Tk plus 1 times vk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 minus 1 times vk is less than or equal to minus 1 over 2 alpha times tk plus 1 times norm of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 square plus 1 over alpha times the inner product of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1. And over here we get tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 minus 1 times xk minus x star. Okay, so let's see again why we get this complicated inequality. So let's look at the left hand side. We multiply the first inequality by tk plus 1 minus 1 and we add to the second inequality. So let's see what we get on the left hand side. We're gonna get tk plus 1 minus 1 times vk plus 1 minus vk, and then we add to the second inequality, that is vk plus 1. Okay, so let's see why we get this. So at first you get tk plus 1 times vk plus 1. Okay, tk plus 1 times vk plus 1, and then we subtract vk plus 1, okay, by the distributive law right here. And then we add tk plus 1 minus 1 times, actually over here we subtract, sorry, times vk. Okay, now tk plus 1 minus 1 times vk, but we have to subtract. And finally we add vk plus 1. Okay, then this one and this one can be simplified. That's why we get tk plus 1 times vk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 minus 1 times vk. That is exactly the left hand side. Okay, now let me explain why we get the right hand side over here. It's also a very, very simple algebra technique. So now we multiply the first one here by tk plus 1 minus 1 and we add to the second inequality. So we're gonna get this minus 1 over 2 alpha times norm of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 square times tk plus 1 minus 1, and then we add minus 1 over 2 alpha times norm of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 square. Okay, so then we're gonna use the distributive law. We take a tk plus 1 and we multiply by this. That's why we get the term over here. And after that, we take this one, we multiply by minus 1, and we simplify with this. That's why, as a result, we only get this. Okay, and now finally, we're gonna work on the last terms here. Okay, we multiply the first one by tk minus 1 and we add to the second inequality. So we keep 1 over alpha yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 right here. And then we only need to take this one and we multiply by tk plus 1 minus 1 and we add to the second one here. That's why we're gonna get this tk plus 1 times yk plus 1. Okay, and then we get minus yk plus 1, and then we simplify with this. Okay, after that we get tk plus 1 minus 1 times xk right here minus sign as well, and then we subtract x star. That's why we get exactly this inequality. Okay, next we're gonna multiply both the sides of this inequality by tk plus 1. Okay, then we're gonna get this tk plus 1 square
times vk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 square minus tk plus 1 times vk is less than or equal to minus 1 over 2 alpha times tk plus 1 square times norm of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 square plus tk plus 1 over alpha times this inner product yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1, and over here we keep the same thing, tk plus 1 yk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 minus 1 xk minus x star. Okay,
so from here to here, it's very simple. We just multiply, again, both sides by tk plus 1. Okay, now, remember a relation we mentioned earlier. So, over here, tk plus 1 square minus tk plus 1 is exactly tk square. So, we only need to replace this one by tk square. So we get a very nice relation. This is tk plus 1 square times vk plus 1, and this is tk square times vk. So let me continue the proof.
Since tk square is equal to tk plus 1 square minus tk plus 1, we're gonna get this. Tk plus 1 square vk plus 1 minus tk square times vk is less than or equal to this, minus 1 over 2 alpha. We put tk plus 1 over here to the square of the norm, so we get this.
Tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 square, and over here we get the same thing, that is tk plus 1 over alpha times the inner product of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1, and over here tk plus 1 yk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 minus xk, and then we subtract x star. Okay, it's a little bit difficult to see over here, but this is just exactly the same as in the previous step. Okay, so in the next step we're gonna do this. So we're gonna factor out this. So we write minus 1 over 2 alpha, and then put a big parenthesis. So over here we get tk plus 1 square times norm. I'm sorry. This is this. Norm of tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 square, okay? And because we factor out minus 1 over 2 alpha, so over here we get this. We get 2 times tk plus 1, okay? 2 times tk plus 1 times the inner product of yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 with tk plus 1 yk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 minus 1 times xk minus x star. That's it. Okay, so very simple. When we multiply back, we will see that this is minus 1 over 2 alpha. This is 2 minus 2 tk plus 1, so that we get exactly tk plus 1 over alpha as over here. Okay, so this is equal to minus 1 over 2 alpha inside of the parentheses, we're going to get this.
Tk plus 1 times xk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 minus 1 times xk minus x star square, and then we subtract this norm of tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 minus 1 times xk minus x star square.
Okay, how come we get this? Remember that this one is norm of a square to a b, so it's going to be norm of a minus b square minus norm of b square. In this situation, what is a? A is this part, okay, and b is right here. Okay, so again, a is tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1. B is tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 minus 1 times xk minus x star. So a minus b will be this. A minus b is tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 minus xk plus 1 minus b, which is here, tk plus 1 yk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 minus 1 xk minus x star. So it is equal to this. We can simplify tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 over here, and we end up having minus tk plus 1 times xk plus 1 minus and minus, it becomes plus right here, tk plus 1 minus 1 times xk plus x star. So we can put the minus sign out, but when we take the norm of a minus b square, then this minus sign disappears and we get norm of this square. And that is exactly what was written right here. Okay? And then this is b, so we get this minus norm of b square, so it's right here. Okay. Now we have the following relation. We have tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 is equal to tk plus 1 times xk plus tk minus 1 times xk minus xk minus 1. Where does this inequality come from? It comes from the definition of yk plus 1 by multiplying both sides by tk plus 1, and we already wrote it over here. Tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 is exactly tk plus 1 times xk plus tk minus 1 times this. Okay? So for simplicity, we're gonna do this. Let uk be this. Be tk times xk minus tk minus 1 times xk minus 1 minus x star. Okay? So what is uk plus 1? Uk plus 1 will be tk plus 1 times xk plus 1. Over here we get tk plus 1, and over here we have xk, and here we have x star. So this is exactly norm of uk plus 1 squared, okay? So then the left-hand side of this inequality is still tk plus 1 squared times vk plus 1 minus tk squared times vk, okay? And it's less than or equal to a very nice expression. This is minus 1 over 2 alpha times norm of uk plus 1 square minus norm of uk square. How come this is exactly norm of uk square? I'm going to explain a little bit more. Let's look at this. Tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 minus tk plus 1 minus 1 times xk minus x star.
This is equal to.
Okay, we're gonna replace tk plus 1 times yk plus 1 by that expression. So it's gonna be tk plus 1 times xk, okay, plus tk minus 1 times xk minus xk minus 1. And then we keep this part the same. So over here we get minus tk plus 1 minus 1 times xk minus x star. Okay, let's see what we can simplify. So over here we get tk plus 1 times xk. Over here we subtract tk plus 1 times xk. So we can simplify. Okay, what else? Over here we get tk times xk. So I'm going to write down. So it's going to be tk times xk. Okay. Now, here we get tk minus 1 times xk minus 1. So I'm going to write minus tk minus 1 times xk minus 1. Okay. And now over here, we also have minus xk. And over here, we get plus xk. That's why we can simplify. And finally, the last one is x star. Okay. So after some simple algebraic manipulation, we're going to get this. Okay. And what is it? This is exactly zk. Okay. So it's a very, very nice identity. And that's why we get this inequality. Okay. And this is true for whatever k in n. Now, let me continue. Focus on this. Okay, so let me start by writing down each of the inequality. So we're gonna get this. T2 square times V2 minus T1 square times V1 is less than or equal to 1 minus 1 over 2 alpha times norm of U2 square minus norm of U1 square. And then this is T3 square V3 minus T2 square V2 is less than or equal to minus 1 over 2 alpha. And over here, it's very simple. It's norm of U3 square minus norm of U2 square. And we keep doing this until Tk square times Vk minus Tk minus 1 square Vk minus 1 is less than or equal to minus 1 over 2 alpha times norm of uk square minus norm of uk minus 1 square. Okay, and then we add all of them together, and then we can simplify everything here. We can simplify everything here. And then we end up having this. Then tk square times vk, okay, minus t1 square times v1, okay, is less than or equal to minus 1 over 2 alpha. Over here, we get norm of uk square minus norm of u1 square. Now, this implies that tk square times vk is less than or equal to t1 square times v1. And then instead of writing minus sign over here, we can interchange the position and get this. Plus 1 over 2 alpha times norm of u1 square minus norm of uk square. Okay. In the next step, we're going to drop this one off. So it's less than or equal to t1 square times v1 plus 1 over 2 alpha times norm of u1 square. Okay. From the definition, we're going to see that t1 is equal to 1. Okay. T1 is equal to 1. What is v1? V1 is f of x1 minus f of x star. Okay, that is v1. And what is u1? u1 if we use the formula for UK, you will see that U1 is exactly X1 minus X star. Okay, and we replace everything to this inequality, and we're going to get this, okay? TK square times VK is less than or equal to this. T1 times V1, that means 1 times f of x1 minus f of x star. And then we add 1 over 2 alpha times norm of u1 square, that is x1 minus x star square. Okay? So to complete the proof, we're going to prove the following. Now, let us show that. Let's show that f of x1 minus f of x star, that means this part is less than or equal to 1 over 2 alpha times norm of x of y1 minus x star square minus norm of x1 minus x star square. Okay, so next we're gonna prove that this is true, and then we plug back in here, okay? So how come this is true? Okay, how come this is true? This is very simple. It follows from the second inequality here. Okay, so let me go ahead and explain this. Indeed, f of x1 minus f of x star can be written as f of g of y1, okay? So f x1 is g of y1 minus f of x star. And now we're gonna apply this inequality. So it's gonna be less than or equal to 1 over 2 alpha times norm of y minus x square, that is norm of y1 minus x star square, minus norm of g of y minus x square. G of y 1 is exactly x1. So we get x1 minus x star square over here, okay? Now, we already proved that this one is less than or equal to 1 over 2 alpha times norm of y1 minus x star square minus norm of x1 minus x star square. And then we're gonna replace this by the right-hand side of this inequality. Then TK square times VK, okay, is less than or equal to 1 over 2 alpha times norm of y1 minus x star square minus norm of x1 minus x star square plus 1 over 2 alpha times norm of x1 minus x star square. Okay. So what can we simplify over here? We can simplify this and here. So this is exactly 1 over 2 alpha times norm of y1 minus x star square. Okay, and what is y1? By the definition, y1 is exactly x0. So this is equal to 1 over 2 alpha times norm of x0 minus x star square. Okay. Let me summarize what we have got. So we get this. TK square times VK is less than or equal to 1 over 2 alpha times norm of x0 minus x star square. And at this point, we can divide both sides by TK square so that we get this. TK VK is less than or equal to norm of x0 minus x star square over 2 alpha times TK square. Remember that Tk is greater than or equal to k plus 1 over 2, as I mentioned at the beginning, and this can be proved by induction. So the whole thing here is less than or equal to this, norm of x naught minus x star square over 2 alpha times k plus 1 over 2 square. Okay, so after simplifying, this is k plus 1 over 4, we simplify 2, and then we multiply by the reciprocal, we're going to get this. Over alpha times k plus 1 square. Okay, and vk, what is vk? Vk is exactly f of xk minus f of x star. And because x star is an absolute minimizer of the function f in Rn, so this is always greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so this is true for all k in n. Okay, so we have completed the proof of the convergence rate of the Nesterov accelerated gradient method. The proof is rather long and involved, and I already tried my best to give the details of every step. So I hope we can understand the proof of this theorem. Let me mention an important case, that is in the case where alpha is 1 over L, where L is the Lipschitz constant of the gradient of the function f. So if alpha is equal to 1 over L, then what are we going to get? We're going to get this. 0 is less than or equal to f of xk minus f of x star, okay? And it's less than or equal to 2 times L times norm of x naught minus x star square over k plus 1 square. Because we simply replace alpha by 1 over L. And this is true for all k in n. X naught here is the starting point. So this is a constant. L is also a constant. So this is similar to 1 over k square. That's why the convergence rate of the Nesterov accelerated gradient method is big O 1 over k square. And this is a big improvement compared with the gradient, the convergence rate of the gradient method, that is 1 over k.